Morocco. Many Americans think of Morocco as a land of hidden mountain villages. A land of primitive crafts. A land of high walled cities. A land where people follow ancient patterns of life. But this concept is not entirely true. Today, Morocco is a country on the move, growing, expanding, developing. In a few decades, great new cities have been built, some as modern as any in the world. Morocco today is truly a part of the 20th century. The country is on the Atlantic Ocean. Situated in the northwest corner of Africa, Morocco faces both Europe and the New World. Morocco has been invaded by waves of conquerors. First, the Phoenicians. And then the Romans in the first Christian century. Most enduring in its effect was the Islamic invasion, which gave Morocco its culture, its politics, and its religion. But Europe intruded. Both Spain and Portugal came, built fortress cities along the coast. In 1812, the French signed the Treaty of Fez with the Moroccan government, establishing a protectorate over the troubled country. In that same year, a French soldier, Marshal Lyautey, re-established order. Lyautey loved Morocco and her people, and respected her customs, her religion, and her government headed by her own sultan. A new era began for Morocco, an age which tied her to Western Europe. Morocco is the Sahara Desert in the south. It is fertile plains in the north, the central spine of the Atlas Mountains, and the Atlantic coastal plains of the west. Throughout the country live the Berbers. They were Morocco's original inhabitants, are traditionally great horsemen, proud warriors. The Berbers are a tribal people of the mountains and desert. They gain their livelihood from the soil. The Arabs who came to Morocco in the 7th century settled in the cities of the north, became teachers and artisans. The Jews also settled in the cities as merchants and craftsmen. And the French came, a half million of them, and settled in Morocco to live and work there. Some as doctors, some as farmers and engineers, and others as teachers. To the free world, Morocco represents a strategic link in the defense chain of Western Europe. At Port Lyautey in the Atlantic Ocean, the French Navy maintains an air base. Through the Treaty of Fez with the Sharifian government, France has built a group of air, naval, and military bases across Morocco as part of her contribution to the Atlantic Alliance. Agreement with the government, the American Navy shares the Port Lyautey base. American jet pilots train here. It is also a supply and servicing station for the American 6th Fleet in the Mediterranean, the only fleet in the U.S. Navy which operates without a home port. The American base at Port Lyautey, like all American bases in Europe, is also part of the NATO defense plan. More important is the United States Air Force complex of bases which stretch across Morocco. Ben Gurir, Nuasir, Boulhard, and Sidi Slimane. At Sidi Slimane, the Strategic Air Command has the 5th Air Division, which supervises flights of the B-47, the speedy stratojet bomber, which would play an important role in any war in Europe and Africa. The USAF deploys its medium bomber wings to Morocco as part of its rotation program for orientation and training of crews. Here is a jet scramble, an interceptor mission against a simulated enemy air attack against these bases. Wisely realizing that the future of the country lies in an educated people, France, with a technical assistance program similar to America's own, has established a nationwide free educational system with particular emphasis on technical training. Both in Morocco and in universities in France, hundreds of young Moroccans study in various advanced fields. They will take a vital part in the future development of their country. Another important field of cooperative endeavor is health. One outstanding example is the new hospital of Rabat, Suisse. This hospital is open to all, Moroccan or European, with free medical services for all who need it. Malnutrition and diseases born of ignorance and dirt still take a heavy toll among the young. But the death rate is falling, while the birth rate and total population have taken a spectacular rise, more than double in 30 years. This hospital, a regional one, gives complete services from internal medicine to surgery. Because of the varying religious dietary demands of the patients, the wards are separated, and Europeans are fed European food, while Muslims and Jews are given their own dishes, according to their religious laws. The hospital opened late in 1954, is already well patronized by Moroccans and Europeans of all classes and backgrounds. Perhaps one of the most lasting reforms instituted under the protectorate is the reform of Muslim law. For centuries, justice was dispensed through an unwritten system of religious and civil laws. Today, the Moroccans and French are codifying and regulating the law of the land. Courts, both civil and criminal, are presided over by Moroccan judges trained in both Muslim and Western legal practices. This is a civil tribunal in Rabat, where each litigant is heard in open court with right of counsel and appeal. And lawyers plead with the same fervor in Morocco as they do in the United States, with perhaps a few more gestures. The codification of Muslim law is a major step in the development of a modern state in this ancient country. Before the advent of the protectorate, fishing in Morocco was small and localized. What did exist was controlled by the Portuguese and the Spanish. Today, fishing is one of the most important Moroccan industries. Some figures: 130,000 tons of fish caught each year, a motorized fleet of 500 boats, 9,000 fishermen, of whom 8,500 are Moroccan. The sardine is the most important fish caught off Morocco's coast. It makes up over half the annual catch. And fish canning has kept a parallel pace with fishing. Over 110,000 tons of fish, valued at over $37 million, are canned each year. Nine-tenths of all the sardines caught, some 97,000 tons, are canned in Morocco. And the canning industry is growing, as has the development of fish fry products. Morocco has some of the world's best citrus fruits: lemons, oranges, clementines, tangerines. The soil and climate are ideal for the cultivation of fruit trees, and a large part of the available land is planted in huge fruit orchards. Much of the fruit is eaten at home, but the great bulk is packed for export. Fruit packing, too, is a growing industry, with huge plants in Casablanca. The fruit is shipped mainly to Europe, an export trade of over 125,000 tons a year. Because agriculture is the basis of Moroccan prosperity, The French, through a farm technical assistance program, are improving agricultural production. Through cooperatives, farmers learn to run mechanized equipment, which they can later use in cultivating their own farms. Another important source of Morocco's natural wealth is the phosphate industry. State-owned, it rates second only to the United States in world production. At Karibga, in central Morocco, the Sharifian Office of Phosphates runs one of the world's most modern superphosphate plants. In less than 30 years, this industry has built whole new towns and villages for the phosphate workers, called Medinas, a Muslim community. At Karibga, the Medinas are complete units with their own schools, libraries, and mosques, or Muslim churches. The Medinas are carefully planned to suit the customs and needs of the Muslim inhabitants. They have their own privately run stores. Here, a phosphate miner is buying a cone of sugar and a package of tea, the national drink. In the new Medinas, every family has the privacy of an individual home. The houses are separate, each with its own courtyard. The Medinas contain from 10 to 40,000 people, whose standard of living has been raised immeasurably in the past three decades through the foresight of this state-owned industry. The decision to exploit the phosphate deposits in the interests of the Sharifian state was Lyotey's, who saw how this mineral would not only benefit the state, which receives all the profits from the mines, but also the workers and their families. Each Medina contains its own hospital, child and maternity centers, and infirmaries, complete with the most modern equipment and staffed by expert nurses and doctors. Social and medical care is free to all the phosphate miners' families.